Hello, we are the GKN Gear Senior Design Team. We worked with GKN Driveline, located in Newton, North Carolina, a Tier 1 supplier of automotive driveline components. GKN Driveline manufactures transmissions, differentials, and axles for companies such as BMW, GM, and Ford.
Our project focuses on optimizing the blade grinding and gear cutting processes of hypoid spiral bevel gears found in the rear differential of the Ford Focus RS. GKN Driveline spends millions of dollars every year on the carbide blades used to cut these gears. Our task was to conduct a series of studies to determine when to regrind the cutter blades and how deep to grind them, such that the cost is reduced without sacrificing the quality of the gears.
Each study consisted of visual blade inspection, individual gear temperature measurements, and spindle vibration monitoring to observe the wear on the cutter blades. Part quality was monitored via surface roughness measurements and GKN's in-process quality parameters such as motion transmission error and noise vibration harshness.
A Fluke infrared thermometer was used to measure each gear's temperature after generation, and a three-axis accelerometer wired to an Arduino collected the spindle vibrations. The gears were generated in batches of 56 parts, which are identified as lots. After each lot, the cutter head was removed from the machine and a DynoLite handheld microscope was used to measure the progression of wear on the blades without removing them from the head. Each gear was engraved so that it could be tracked throughout the plant and its quality could be monitored in the preceding processes.
Upon analysis of the three baseline studies, accompanied with process statistics, it was determined that the blades should not cut more than four lots of gears without being reground. The varying regrind depths of the cutter blades used in the subsequent studies were determined from the observed wear on the blades during the baseline studies. In the end, it was determined that the regrind depth could safely be reduced from 1 mm from the tip of the tool to 0.75 mm, increasing tool life. In addition, there was no negative impact evident on the part quality.
And finally, thank you to our supporters and mentors for your time, resources, and guidance through this project.